Sean, and what happened outside court as well. There was a small crowd that gathered here as the co-defendants were led into the court. Some of them were shouting at the defendants that they would be damned. Now, the first to appear in court was Christopher Gribble, who prosecutors say stabbed the victim, Kimberly Cates, several times. Gribble is charged with first-degree murder, attempted murder, and conspiracy to commit murder. Stephen Spader was allegedly wielding a machete when he entered the home at Fortrow Road in Mount Vernon. Prosecutors allege that he struck the victim with the machete and that he also delivered a similar blow to the victim's 11-year-old daughter. A prosecutor alleges that Spader drove the four co-defendants to the home where the murder occurred. And while only two of the co-defendants were charged with murder, the prosecution says that all four, none of them shied away from what happened.
The homeowner was killed in her bed, and a young child was very, very seriously injured. The information that the state has developed to date was that all four of these defendants were aware before they entered the home that the intent was to kill.
18-year-old William Marks was also arraigned this morning. He is charged with burglary, conspiracy to commit burglary, and armed robbery. Also arraigned, 17-year-old Quinn Glover, who faces similar burglary charges, conspiracy to commit burglary, and armed robbery. Now, we will have much more on this case. The parents of some of the defendants are inside. We'll have much more on this case and the developments later on, news beginning at News 9 at 5. For now, reporting live outside Milford District Court, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.